Since the Artsy Arabia collection included four styles of 12x12 paper, a first for Marlene, I decided to create something fun and different from them. In today's 5 Minutes of Fun video, I'll show you how to fold and glue the paper to create a 6x6 journal that can include as many pages as you want. This is a really simple process and something that you can accomplish in a couple of hours. It's also easy enough for kids to try and be successful, especially if an adult does the cutting. So the first step when you look at a 12x12 piece of paper, and specifically these papers that Studio Light created for Art by Marlene, this is a 12x12 piece of paper. But with that said, this is a 6x12 ruler. I cut this 6-inch strip off, and if I put the ruler on here, you can see that there is going to be that white selvage that needs to come off that identifies the product and has all the information on it. But you can see that there's also another little tiny strip on there. So this is a touch more than 12 inches. So don't come and just trim the white off. Make certain that what you're creating are two strips that measure 6 inches by 12 inches. So once you do that, you're gonna be left with a stack of papers that are 6x12, and you'll need to fold them in half. Now, if I fold this way, this will be what I see inside the signatures of the book. And the backside is what is going to be glued to a subsequent signature to create these pages. So all you have to do is line this up, grab a bone folder, and just go ahead and put a good crease in it. Once you have a stack of these ready to go, and you can see that I have several of them here, you start to assemble these pages into, or these signatures into a book. And what you'll notice is that this is a single thickness, but because I've put two back to back here, a little bit of sticky from the glue, because I've put the two back to back, I now have a double thickness right here. And ultimately, I'm gonna put one individual piece here and one on the back, and that's what's going to make my covers. But let's not get too far ahead. So if I grab a piece of just plain printer paper so that I kind of keep the mess to a minimum, I'm going to use a Dylusions glue stick. And those of you who watch the videos know that I use these because they simply work. These are very inexpensive. They're less than $1 a piece for this, and I think I ended up with 2 pages each times 2 pieces, so that's 16 pieces of paper, and I'm probably going to use 2 to 3 glue sticks. They're very inexpensive, but they just work. So when I do this, I'm going to start by putting adhesive on this. This, as far as I'm concerned, is the most important piece of this book. I want to make certain that I have glue around all of the edges, but particularly on the spine, because that's the place where there's going to be the most pressure. It's the place where you're going to open the book up, and you're going to want to make certain that everything is held together there well there. So what I do is, the last thing I do is go around the perimeter of the page to make certain that I have enough adhesive there. So I'm going to grab this so that I have a different page, and all I'm going to do is just pull this toward me and line this up. And mostly I'm doing this with my fingers. Quite honestly, most of you know that I'm not big on perfection. I'm really good at being imperfect, and why should I change that? I don't care if the pages are not exactly perfect. It's okay with me. So that is how you start stacking all of these pages or all of these signatures together to make a page. And when you're satisfied with however many you have, the next step is to glue the covers on. And so the way to do that is by taking one strip. Now, you can take one strip like I did and cut it in half. You can take a half from one strip and a half from an entirely different sheet and glue them on there. It's really up to you. I mean, you can choose, if you wanted to get white watercolor paper and make a white cover, you could do that too. So same process. All I'm going to do is come in with my handy dandy glue stick, and I'm going to get adhesive all the way around, paying real close attention to the edges and obviously at the back on that spine. Now, something that you could do, something that I could do, would be to slip another piece of paper under there so that if I overrun, I don't hit the pages underneath. I just didn't do it this time. I mean, most of the time I do, but not this one. All right, again, just making certain that I get all the way around. Now, bearing in mind that, whoops, my book is going to be like this, I'm thinking a little bit about the way that I want to place this. So I'm going to, again, I'm going to kind of stand up and look down on this so I can get this on here adjusted. And that's the nice thing about the glue stick. Because it's not instant stick, it does allow you the flexibility to move things around a little bit if you need to. All right, so there's one cover on. I'm going to flip this over, and I'll do the same thing with the other cover. As always, there will be links to the products down below, and everything is eligible for our everyday, a 15% off everyday discount, so you'll keep that in mind as you shop. I think I'm going to turn this one this way, go ahead and get it lined up. Again, with the glue stick, I can kind of wiggle things around a little bit, press it in place. So now I have everything done, but covering the spine rather. So all I'm going to do is, I have some canvas hanging around. I tore a piece that kind of fits. Now I'm probably not going to use glue stick for this, only because I want to make certain that this canvas really sticks. And so for that, I'll probably use a liquid glue. It's a very simple matter of finding the center, sticking the spine down on the center, and then folding these edges up like this and gluing them in place. And once you do that, your book is done. Now you could do this with some thin paper if you wanted. In fact, the Art by Marlene collage papers probably would work well to wrap around the spine like this. And honestly, that's how easy it is to make a really nice 6x6 journal out of these 8 new Art by Marlene 12x12 pieces of scrapbook paper. Super simple, lots of fun.